Hello children, today we are going to continue our chapter 15, the peninsular plateaus or the southern plateau. Already we have discussed about its location and its shape. Okay, what's the shape of southern plateau children? Cone in shape. And also we saw that it is divided by river Narmada into two parts. That is, one is the Deccan Plateau and another one is Central Highlands. Again, we saw Central Highland is divided into two again, that is Malwa Plateau and Chotanagar Plateau. And Deccan Plateau, we saw there are many rivers originating in that is river Mahanadi, Krishna, Godavari and Kaveri. And Godavari is one of the sacred river of India, and also it is also known as the Dakshin Ganga. Okay, in today's class we are going to discuss about life of the people of Peninsular Plateau.
States in Southern Plateau. Some parts of Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh and Chhattisgarh lie in the peninsular plateaus. Maharashtra. Maharashtra lies in the northwestern part of the Deccan Plateau. It has rich soil. The Godavari and Krishna passes through this region. Most of the people are farmers. They grow cotton, jowar, bajra, groundnuts, sugarcane and fruits like oranges, grapes and mangoes. Nagpur is famous for its oranges. Mumbai is the capital of Maharashtra. Other important cities in Maharashtra are Pune, Nasik, Solapur and Aurangabad. Marathi is the main language of the people in Maharashtra. The famous Ajanta and Ellora caves are in Aurangabad. The gateway of India is in Mumbai. The people are fond of music and dance. Tamasha is the most popular drama. Lavani is a popular dance. Men wear dhoti shirt while women wear a 9-yard sari tied in a special way. The most important festival of Maharashtra is Ganesh Chaturthi. Next, we are going to see the life of the people of Karnataka. To the south of Maharashtra is Karnataka. Krishna, Tungabhadra and Kaveri rivers flow through this state. Most of the people are farmers. The main crops grown are jowar, ragi, cotton, coffee, sugarcane and spices. Bengaluru is the capital of Karnataka. It is known as the Garden City because of its many parks. It is a big industrial center. It has many factories producing aeroplanes, watches, telephones, machinery, etc. Recently, a boom in the information technology industry has made it world famous. It is now called Silicon Valley of the East. Main cities are Mysuru, Hubali, Belagavi and Dharwar. Men wear dhoti shirt. Women wear sari and blouse. The main language is Kannada. People are fond of music and dance. Yakshagan is the traditional folk theatre of Karnataka. Carnatic music is popular throughout the country. Mysore city name is changed into Mysuru. Mysuru is famous for its Dasara celebrations at the Mysuru Palace and Vrindavan Gardens. Dog Hall is also in Mysuru. Next, we are going to see the life of the people of Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu lies to the east of Karnataka. Farming is the main occupation of the people. Rice, sugarcane, cotton, and groundnuts are the main crops grown. In the hills of the Nilgiri, coffee and tea are grown. Tamil Nadu is one of the most industrialized states of India. In the integral coach factory at Perambur makes railway coaches. Kanchipuram is famous for its silk saris. Chennai is the capital of Tamil Nadu. Tamil is the main language. South Indian food comprises dosa, idli, upma and sambar. It is popular all over the country. The men wear lungi and shirt. The girls wear long skirt called pavadai. Bharatanatyam is the classical dance form of Tamil Nadu. Pongal is the most important festival. Tamil Nadu is famous for its temples. Some of the famous temples are Meenakshi Temple at Madurai, Nadaraj Temple at Chidambara, and Rameshwaram Temple at Rameshwaram. I hope today's class is clear. Thank you all.